you guys, I am having such a good time. I think it's nice when you hang around young people. They've got good vibes. They're all young. They are free to buy in a stress, to buy in a bana, so you can't talk about kids. I mean, they're just enjoying their life. How old are you, John Black?
22.
You can imagine. I am here chilling with a 22-year-old and...
22.
So, can you imagine?
Age meant.
They are age meant.
See, come on. I've lost a good man.
You've lost a good man. Why? You thought he was older?
Okay, I'm 32.
Can you imagine? I'm chilling here with 22-year-olds. It's so nice. It's a breath of fresh air. Pia, what has been your biggest highlight of 2018?
The highlight actually has been a tragedy.
A tragedy?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
After I was signed,
mm-hmm.
right away we came, mm-hmm. was in
a... Oh, Bombay.
And you know, before he died, like a few months ago, he met me and was like, the way you sing, I would like to sing with you.
Oh.
That was the biggest kwana of all time. Like, I was like, he doesn't even need to say a lot. I'm in, nigga.
You're in. You were entered.
Now
he's no more. Yeah. Sorry. John Black, I know one of your biggest inspirations, the person who inspired you most, is also Moze Radio.
Moze Radio, ne?
Me, I don't invite someone on this show when I know nothing about them. I'm not like I know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
So I know Moze Radio inspires you.
Yeah.
What was the biggest? How did it feel like when you heard that radio has died? What were you doing? Where were you? What were you? Who were you? Whom were you doing when you had?
By then, I had already released my single called Romantic.
Okay.
So I got the inspiration from the song called Romantic Call.
Oh.
Did you know that song?
Yes, radio song.
Nakugamba, ndingwagala, nalingulimba. Nugena nininanga, mvulinga, ngamanyanga, changa.
So kwa inako kama saji kano kenzo ingot. Obugalo buli.
Bugu onda bulinga mfali.
Odio so?
Yeah, kati when I had that song, I was also inspired. Like, I was like, let me come up with something different. But romantic, by the way. Go, abamu bantegira kutuku watagani. Na yaba singa, eh? Mwinda, so bantegira ku romantic.
You were romantic, you were romantic, baby.
The lyrical maturity. Binda binda natulanga, nefudent kambele radio.
Okay.
Ganko yoku wandike vintu yabu abuli job. By then, nakuma na kula koli mba yuta tombala. Nga hip hop. Just rapping, nga temuli chama. Just bigambo kusembia yo chuchu, ba ba ba. So I was like,
got our rhymes.
Ngamba radio yankudde kana akayimba. Woli adala akakunyumira.
Yes.
Ngana naye kankuli akayimba kwa ita romantic. Era Andre yakankolera. Andre ngamba gwe kana akayimba kwa wakoze to man. Nendoza anti ba producer bo nabe nagawa yogera nga yagala omwe balance we. Gwe bigende bikusukeko. Lakini na produce eh abantu nga yagala omaleyo akusudia aiza no gana kaima kagenda kagenda crossinga
mubiyene bikusebe kusuka ko
so kati na kola kakaimba sat subira kaimba ke chakana chiga anti oba siga manti oba chi kuba na internet ndi upcome ibi chibi kina kaimba kaitawo kaimba ke kama nyisa abaswanzi okumpa sweet love
eh collab
na maniga Gamaze Radio.
Oh, Bambi.
Simani oba waliwali musinga. Ndifa gwe nsikiza
nti
omimbi asinga.
Nafe tetumanyi oba waliwali musinga. Na ye tukiriza nti awakule nume tewakule mu. So we hopefully there's a Moze Radio who is like just gearing up to come through in 2019. And you never know when you hear a radio story, he will tell you all the things that he did.
Then I used to meet on a radio. We had never met.
Exactly.
You've
never met.
He's a crazy guy. And
hopefully you guys would have, and you know what, radio would have loved to work with you.
Very
because
much.
Your voice is unique.
Very much.
He would have harmonized your voice like twafirwa nyo by the way. Ndoja kwesangayo mwalali. So what, okay, well, we can't even say what was your lowest moment of 2018. Maybe there's a low, is there a moment lower than radio's death?
No, there isn't. Out about to dawaguru. We're going up.
We're going higher. We're going up. All right. So you personally, you as a musician in your career, what has been your biggest moment of 2018?
I remember that the day, it was 11th January when I was signed. I thought they're going to sign me. We move on with our lives.
Yes.
I want to bang up a big talent. Oh my God. My family and friends, people who knew about it before it going public, they told me, Eddie Kenzo never wants anybody to be a star. Oh my God, you're going to suffer. So when he signed me, what happened? Mary, I was in my own things. You know, I used to study from IUAA. In fact, all boda guys on Gaba Road are my friends.
Because they used to take us to
school. I used to buy clothes from downtown, Nabugabo, people uptown, from India and Turkey. So now, after being signed, everything changed. Like, I didn't know fame was that sweet.
Oh.
I would go to bank to, you know, put my ngandim line, and then some nigga would come from there like, Pia, Madam Pia, how are you? Fine. I took some kind of VIP section and be like, damn.
And that's just the beginning.
Yeah, anyways.
Let me tell you.
The child is too much for me because it has never happened. Mm-hmm. So it was... Oh. That's why
you don't know Pia. I can't even me, I don't do interviews, so I don't tell people my story. But to relate with you, I have never, my God, I don't know the last time I stood in a bank queue. I don't know the last time I went to a place and I didn't get someone running out to me to help me. But now me, because of the brand that I created, that Jenenyu Milizamu, by the way, I've never regretted the brand that I created, is that some people are like, ha, why go? Why don't go? I don't know if I go. And she says, so, and I like it, by the way. I like it because Zasimanyirwa, let me tell you, no one is going to ever walk up to me and just say, everyone is, Nze, Simanyirwa Sikwanibwa. And I love it.
Wait a minute.
I love it.
Sikwanibwa. Mary, I saw you being vibed one night.
Who, by who?
The guy was white.
Mary, even useless. No, you don't understand. I'm the one asking the questions, you guys. Mm-hmm. Don't even be funny. John Black, what has been the biggest moment of your career so far? 2018. What do you look back to and say, wow, you even smile and you're like, wow, that was the day.
Yeah. I remember that too.
Mm-hmm.
Was that event was organized at Uganda Museum.
Yes.
Rolex Festival. Still, it was.
Mm-hmm.
I never expected what I received.
Yes.
So I was like going like these normal artists.
Mm-hmm.
I was surprised to step on the stage when everybody started shouting my name.
Mm-hmm.
They sang all my songs, and I was like,
eh. And it was a big crowd. So you wake up in the morning, you're going to sing at Rolex Festival, you're like,
Even the white dress, I was like, let me just go, I perform. And
no one knows me.
Yeah.
That's the mentality. You're thinking, no one knows me, no one cares about me. Let me just go, like, I perform and go.
Like these normal artists, upcoming artists.
Ati, wait about normal artists. upcoming artists, man, you don't block. And that's then again,
so I stepped on the stage, everyone was just shouting my name. John Black. I was surprised. I felt like collapsing. I didn't know what to do. Like, what to bring in next? Cause I was surprised. You know.
I watched you perform recently. You took off your shirt and gave it out.
Dinner Fest.
Yes. You took off your watch and he gave out everything. He gave out his shirt.
He gave out you.
Exactly.
Let me tell you this. When I went backstage, I was like, my watch. I wrote it 150. Can you imagine?
When I saw you giving out that watch, I knew that you're going to regret it. But you got carried away.
but I killed it.
You killed it, yeah.
You know, sometimes you have to give back.
Mm-hmm.
Our fans are our bosses, so sometimes you have to give back the little you have.
Yeah. You killed it, by the way. He's an amazing performer. Yeah. You know, I keep telling people, A-Pass was a hit. Him as a musician was hit. His songs were hits. A-Pass would step on stage and you're like, but you love the songs, you enjoy the songs when they play them in the club, you shout, you even undress. Mm. But when he steps on that stage, he shrinks.
Are you seeing how silent we are?
I don't expect you guys to say anything. Mama will come back and talk more about 2018. You could also share your highlights and your low moments. We just talked about Moses Radio. Where were you when you heard the news that Radio died? How did it make you feel? Did you play his music immediately? Did you feel bad? I felt bad. I felt like it just went like... So share with us your lowest and your highlights of 2018. We'll be talking more about that. We're going to spread it. Socially. Everything. We'll be talking about that. So don't go anywhere. Use the hashtag Salon Talk, and I will be right back with these two.